Hey everybody, I'm Shane from Admin Arsenal. In a previous video, we showed you how you could use Xcopy and PDQ Deploy to copy files to all your computers from a central file server. That was using Xcopy. You can see that package that we had used right there. Some folks wrote in and said, hey, how about Robocopy? Why can't you do that? Well, you can. Robocopy is available on almost all of the operating systems from Microsoft. You will find it hit and miss on some XP. So just keep that in mind. But Vista on forward is pretty much a slam dunk. You can see we've got two command steps in here. We don't have an install step. And all we're running is Robocopy, which once again has to exist on the target, and specifying the source directory and the target directory. And we're passing it the MIR, the slash MIR parameters, which means mirror. Basically, it's a way of saying it's Robocopy's parameters saying make the target destination look exactly like the source. So this is going to copy the tests directory. I'm going to go ahead and deploy this right now. Control D. You just type in the name of Quintana. That's this computer, so you can see the files get copied. Now it's going to copy these files, but it's going to come back as a failed deployment. And that's what I want to call out, because this is what you have to remember with Robocopy. So there's the tests directory. You can see that got copied just fine. However, it failed, and it failed with an error code 1. Error code 1 in Robocopy actually means success. It means that files were copied. So we're going to come into our package here and actually modify the success codes. 0 is also a success. There's various levels of success codes for Robocopy. I'm going to change that to 1 and then do this on the same command here. If you notice, we've got two different command sets, one for XP, one for non-XP. And that's because XP, we're using a different variable for the desktop. And of course, those are set via conditions, only run on XP versus step 1, which runs on everything else. So now I'll save that. We're going to deploy this, redeploy. It's going to copy the files again, and you're going to see a success code. And there it is. It was successful. So just keep in mind, with Robocopy, you do need to modify your success codes, and go for it. A lot of people, myself included, find Robocopy to actually be a little bit more efficient than Xcopy. All right, I'm Shane. Cheers.